Hello guys, welcome back to my video channel. In this video, I will be discussing some of the ecological terms. Those are ecosystem engineer, then foundation species, and then indicator species, and then flagship species, and finally umbrella species. So without making any delay, let's start one by one, which is the first one, that is ecosystem engineer. Ecosystem engineers are species that create, okay, that a species that are going to create and modify their environment in a significant manner, means creating new habitats or modifying existing ones to suit their needs. Here, ecosystem engineers are species, means they are trying to modify the existing habitat, or they are trying to build a new environment which are very useful for them. Okay, those are called as ecosystem engineer. Okay, in simple terms, which means that they play a critical role in their environment and affect many other species in the ecosystem. Okay, that means through their activities, ecosystem engineers significantly affect other species by providing and maintaining micro habitats that wouldn't otherwise exist. Okay, so by their activities, they will helpful for the other species also, because they are going to create micro habitats, okay, these micro habitats are useful for the other species as well. So in other words we can define like this also, like ecosystem engineers can often be defined as keystone species. I guess I have explained about keystone species in the previous video, where I have discussed about ecological compression, then ecological dominance, and keystone species and landscape species. If you didn't watch that video, you can go back to that video and watch it. There I explained what are keystone species. So here can sometimes even ecosystem engineer species can also called as a keystone species that shows dramatic effect or causes dramatic changes on its habitat. Okay, those are called as ecosystem engineers. And in ecosystem engineers, there are two types, that is allogenic engineer, second one autogenic engineer. First one, allogenic engineer. Allo means different. Okay, the meaning of allo means different. Okay, these organisms modify environment by converting materials mechanically from one form into another form. Okay, those are called as allogenic ecosystem engineer or allogenic engineer. Example for this is caterpillars. And moving on to the next one, that is second one, autogenic engineer. These organisms modify the environment by modifying or converting themselves. Okay, here allogenic engineers, they convert the materials, but here in case of autogenic engineers, they will modify themselves. Auto means self. Okay, so example for this is tree. Let us move on to the next term, that is foundation species. This is very simple, very easy to understand. It is answer, most of the answer will be in the name itself. See, foundation species means that species that provides foundation of a habitat, you can say simply like that. But here is the definition, you can take this as consideration. This definition is here. The foundation species are species that have a strong role in structuring a community. Those are called as foundation species. Example for this is producers. Foundation species are species that have a strong role in structuring a community. Okay, those are called as foundation species. Example for this is producers, primary producers, or you can simply say producers. So, and one more point I would like to add here is that keystone species do not form the ecosystem, but they help the ecosystem keep it going. Okay, whereas foundation species provides the foundation of a habitat. Okay, I will repeat once again. Keystone species do not form the ecosystem, but they help it keep it going. But whereas A foundation species provides the foundation of a habitat. Okay. Let us move on to the next term. Here is the next term, that is indicator species. Indicator means, you know, the in simple English term, you know, the indicator means which represents something, right? So here is the definition. These species represents a trait or characteristic feature of its habitat. Okay, those are called as indicator species. Or you can say like this also, an indicator species is an organism whose presence or absence or its abundance reflects a specific environmental condition. Those are called as indicator species. For example, you can take the example of catkers. See, if you look at the catkers, what you remember, you will remember the desert, right? Catkers represent the desert. And one more example you can give, you can take the example of camel. Camel, if you see the camel, you will remember the desert. Okay, so that's why indicator species that indicates, represents a trait. So few more example I would like to give is if you take the example of lotus. Lotus represents, lotus you can say water, it will, and the zebra, grassland. Mosses, it will indicate the acid soil. And if you see the river otters, actually represents a healthy, clean river system. Okay, if you see lichens actually air pollution indicator, those are. So how much sulfur dioxide is in the air, that if you see the lichen, you can say that how much percent of sulfur dioxide is in the air. And that means lichens represents the air pollution. Those are called as indicator species. It is very simple and easy. Let us move on to the next term, that is flagship species. These are the another name for the flagship species is charismatic species. Okay, and these are the species used as symbol for defining its habitat or environmental issue or environmental causes or conservation effect. Okay, these species used as a symbol to defining its habitat. For example, Bengal tiger, then Asian elephant, then African elephant, then giant pandas are used as a flagship species. Okay, so let us move on to the next terms. Next one is umbrella species. These umbrella species are those species selected for conservation whose protection involves the indirect protection of other species in the community. Those are called as umbrella species. Means if you protect some kind of animal, that protection of that animal will help in the indirect protection of the other species. Those species are called as umbrella species. See, if you take the example of the umbrella. So, if you carry an umbrella, so who are other persons with you? Those are also get protected by the umbrella. So like that. So, if you conserve a kind of species, that will indirectly protect the other species. Or you can define like this also: a species whose requirement includes the requirement of all other species in the community, that is called as umbrella species. Example for this is Project Tiger. Okay, I hope this video will be helpful for you all. And if you are new to this channel, please do subscribe to my channel. And if you like this video, please hit a like button. And thank you, everyone.